Thank you very much, Pastor Rutherford. And if everyone could just give me a big round of applause for the pastor and the whole congregation for opening up their doors to us this evening and being so hospitable. We really appreciate it. And, you know, as the pastor said, my name is Robert Glassman, and I am an attorney with the law firm of Panache Boyle in Los Angeles here. And on behalf of our entire legal team, I would like to welcome you to this very important town hall meeting that we are having here at the Shepherd of the Hills in Porter Ranch. As you all probably know, the Southern California Gas Company indicated that for the very first time on October 23rd of this year, there was a gas leak, at least that's what they're calling it, up in Aliso Canyon up the street. And here we are, 2 months later, and they haven't done anything about it. They haven't fixed the leak, they haven't stopped it, and they have indicated to us and to you that it's not going to be until several months from now until they do anything about it. Well, what we say to that is that they have failed you. They have failed every single person in your community. And, you know, that's why we're here. That's why we're here, okay? Because every time they send an email out to you, every time they make a post on social media or make a statement in the press about how this gas isn't dangerous, is not toxic to you, to your children, to your parents, to your pets, well, that's a slap in the face. And that's why we're here. We're here to fight for you. That's what our job is. And just like in every big major legal battle, there's various areas that we need to explore and talk about. And that's the point of this evening. Because tonight you're going to hear from a number of experts in different disciplines who are going to offer different perspectives about this situation facing your community. And what I'd like to do now is I'd like to introduce you to the people you're going to be hearing from. First, you're going to be hearing from Rex Paris. Rex is an attorney, a founding partner at the law firm of RX Paris in Lancaster. Rex is widely considered one of the most innovative and successful trial lawyers in this state and in the country. And he's going to talk to us a little bit about the litigation strategy, about the cases that we've already filed and that we're going to file, and what some of our legal claims are. Then you're going to hear from a panel of medical experts, and I'm going to kind of go through the line here. You're going to hear from Dr. Ronald Fisk. Dr. Fisk, why don't you stand up? Dr. Fisk is a neurologist at Cedars-Sinai Hospital in Los Angeles. Next, we have Dr. Anthony Redding. Dr. Redding is a clinical psychologist and a professor at the UCLA School of Medicine. Thank you, Dr. Redding. Next, we have another attorney, Patricia Oliver. She's going to be talking to you a little bit about relocation. That's a big issue facing the community. And she's going to bring up some people who have just gone through the process, the Katz family, and she's going to talk to you about that. And it's a really horrible situation. It's a really horrible situation right now during the holidays, and so she's going to talk to you about what we're doing to help our clients in that regard. Next, we have Dr. Richard Kang. And Dr. Kang, he's a pediatrician. He practices critical care medicine for children. And, you know, we know this exposure to the gas is very dangerous to our children out there, and he's going to talk to you a little bit about that. Next, who do we have next to you, Dr. Kang? Okay, we've got Dr. Brooks Michaels. Dr. Michaels practices family medicine and specifically geriatrics, so he's going to talk to you a little bit about that, and he's going to offer some perspectives about some of our elderly people and how we can avoid problems going forward. And finally, we have the veterinarian, Dr. David Smith. And Dr. Smith, you're going to talk to us about our pets. Okay, because as we've heard from you, This is affecting our pets too, not just our children, not just our families. So he's going to talk to you a little bit about that. So why don't we go ahead and get started and hear from Rex. Why don't you take it away?
Good evening. So you've all heard different things about how the lawsuits are being filed, who's filing them, and it has to be incredibly confusing. I recognize that, you know, every lawyer in the country is knocking on your door. That's regrettable, but to be expected, I think. Like, what we're attempting to do tonight is to just give you the raw information. And so let me tell you what's happened so far. The first thing we did is we filed a lawsuit. It's called a class action, and everybody's been told about that and confused by that. So I want to clarify what that is. One of the things we want to accomplish is to have them stop doing this, to have them stop poisoning your community. The way to do that, we thought that the best way to do that, the most efficient way, was to file the class action. And the goal of that is to stop it so we're not here 2 years from now when the next well blows. That's the reason that's filed. That has nothing to do with your individual claims. So don't be confused by that. The class action is not protecting you for your individual claims. A problem that we've run into is the state's liability for this. That field, along with several other fields, have not been regulated according to the law. There's not any question about that. They can't deny it because a month before this well blew, a report came out that said 76% of every injection well in Los Angeles County was permitted illegally. That's their report, that's not our report. 76% of every one of these wells was done illegally. So when we asked the state to give us every type of gas escaping from that well, and where it's going, and where they're monitoring, what do they do? Now remember, the law requires them to do that. We're not asking for something we're not entitled to. The law says that information has to be available to you. They lawyered up, and that's what that letter is. They're not giving it to us. They lawyered up. And I can understand why they did. I can understand why they did. Crimes have been committed. Make no mistake about that. So, next week, we will go to court, we will ask the judge to compel them to tell us what gases you are breathing and what gases your children are breathing. We shouldn't have to do that, but that's what we're going to do. That's the next step in the litigation. And then we had come to the individual claims. There are thousands of people in this community that are affected. If you own property in the community, your property values are going to be affected. There's nothing anybody can do about that. You will suffer a loss if you do not file a lawsuit to get compensated for it. But I want to talk to you about the people who are having health claims. It is critically important that if you are having health problems, that you get treated. It's also critically important that if you're not, don't. This litigation should be comprised of people who can, with absolute sincerity, say what problems they're having. It should not be populated by anybody who did not have physical symptoms. If you haven't had it, don't claim it. It's, you know, it's as simple as that. It's what our mom told us when we were growing up. Let's keep it that way throughout the litigation. We are now in the process of filing with the court each one of those individual claims. And you want to understand the enormity of the cost here. Just to file the complaints, it's $430-some. Multiply that by 2,000. We're looking at $1 million almost $1 million, just to file the complaints. Why is that important to you? You want to be very careful that the people who are representing you have the ability to represent you. That's why I put four firms together. Not one of us had the ability to do it by ourselves. Did I do that? There we go. $435 to file the suit. And that is just the beginning. By the time this litigation is done, it's going to be $7-8 million in fees, experts, investigation, court costs. It's incredibly expensive. That's why you need a group that can sustain that type of effort. So, what's next? After we get it all filed, they'll start doing depositions where people come in under oath, they ask questions, they ask the experts questions, and more importantly, we get to ask them questions. And they have to answer us. And we will find out exactly what happened up there, how long it's been happening, and what were the gases that have been seeping into this community for the last 10 years. This is not a two-month problem. What we've discovered is this has been ongoing for a long time. This was just a major blowout. That's why everybody's here today. It's the most massive gas blowout, in a populated area in history. This has never happened before in a populated area. And so when they tell you that it's not damaging, it's just temporary, whatever nonsense they're feeding you, understand nobody knows. It's never happened before. If you're having symptoms, make sure you get treated. Make sure you go to your doctors, find out what's going on and what you should do to lessen the impact. The people that are most at risk are people my age. You know, it's really hard for me to say that. People over 60, we're the most vulnerable population. People with health conditions, people with any type of chronic disease, this can be deadly. Make sure you're getting treated. The other at-risk population is our children. You know, they're developing. Nobody knows what breathing this stuff constantly is doing to them. And let me tell you what the defense is. How many people here have been reading the newspaper, watching the television, and as the gas company says, this is just the smell you're reacting to. It's just temporary. It's not a problem. It's not serious. How many have heard that? Now, these people aren't stupid. How could somebody possibly say that? We have children whose noses are bleeding every day. We have people who suffer from chronic headaches every single day. We have people that are nauseous every single day. How does that not become a serious issue? So why are they saying something nobody here believes? It's they're building the defense. They know the lawsuit is coming, and they're trying to convince everybody that it's all in our heads. It's a trick. It's a trick invented by lawyers. Make no mistake, that's what's happening, and that's why you must document everything. Every dime this has cost you, write it down. Put it in a spreadsheet if you do Excel. Every dime. We do not want to cover 1 cent that you're not entitled to. But we want to recover every cent they took from you. That's what's called fairness. And we want this thing at the end to be fair. If you don't document it, it's going to be extraordinarily difficult to do that. So write it down. And when the dust settles, when it's hopefully they have closed that facility, We are attempting to do that through the litigation process, but we also have to do it through the political process. I mean, come on, folks. You have a gas storage facility that we know the wells will blow where people live? That's insanity. We all know that's insanity. It's time our leaders recognize it's insanity and they close it. But when the dust settles, we will do appraisals of everybody's property, and we will know exactly what it has cost in regards to the diminishment in the value of your property. And that we will recover along with everything else. So there it is. That's where we are. That's where we're going. Hopefully it will be quick. It rarely is. Thank you.